Hey guys, before we get into today's video, I wanted to give a huge shout out and a thank you to our sponsor today, Guitario. As a lot of you have shared, you're having difficulty learning guitar because it's just really unorganized going through the video format on YouTube and trying to figure out what I should learn, what order I should do it in, or even if you're doing it right. Guitario is a service that provides step-by-step guitar lessons. They have a wide range of lesson plans that teaches you blues, rock, rhythm, lead, fingerstyle, reading music, and there's a lot more on there. And an area that a lot of musicians have a huge gap is actually music theory, and they provide music theory lessons on there as well. Definitely go check out their music theory lesson plan series. It gives you little bite sizes of information to absorb and really comprehend. Try a 7-day free trial, no credit card required, at www.guitario.com/becomethenight. Make sure you put that become the night at the back so that they know that I sent you. All right, guys, on with the show.
Hey guys, it is Mike with Become the Night. Welcome back to another Song Suggestion Friday. This is the show where you put your suggestions in the comments below. And as of next week, I will be changing some of the rules. As always for the rules, please only make one suggestion per week in the comments or on Patreon. Typically, I would take some songs from the comments, throw them in a poll on Patreon, and certain patrons would also put their suggestions in the poll on Patreon. Next week, it is going to change. The poll will be only for patron suggestions, and I will take 5 of those suggestions every week. The other 5, I will take from the comments section myself. I think we'll be able to get a little bit of a better balance here. I may slightly adjust some of the rules because I know a lot of times in these polls, the most popular songs always crop up to the top. And I know that that can get annoying from time to time, not only for me, but for you. So if I do decide to change the rules a little bit slightly, I will let you know. I grade these songs on a plus sign, equal sign, minus sign. Plus sign means I would actively seek that song out again. Minus sign means I would actively avoid that song. Let's begin. Be Quiet and Drive by the Deftones. I am not sure what's going on in this intro, but honestly, I kind of dig it. Lots of major sevenths, some add nines. This kind of reminds me of a heavier flavor of Incubus or even a little bit of Smashing Pumpkins, and the vocals actually a little reminiscent of Alice in Chains. I actually really love the vocals in this. I mean, I shouldn't say love. But I really dig them a lot, and they're really not my style, but they fit very well with the music. The guitar tone is definitely a little outdated, but honestly, I still like it anyway, especially for the riffs that are being played. The melody is great throughout the song. The chorus is very atypical. The bridge was a little bit of a letdown. I was hoping I could get a little bit more contrast, a little bit more dynamic in the song, but it wasn't terrible. The song is very repetitive and lacks a little more contrast than what I would like. But definitely not as much of a monotone type of dynamic as we had last week with Devin Townsend's Kingdom. The drum mix is great, the bass tone nice and warm. Honestly, it's a good song. Total grade for this song, equal sign.
Zombie!
By Bad Wolf. Now, originally I thought that there was something clipping pretty damn hard in the intro, and it turns out that was just some artificial distortion. Really wasn't a fan of that. It was kind of distracting and just not pleasant. The piano was pleasant. The melodies in this song are great. I mean, I am very biased in favor of this song. I grew up listening to it when I was very young. My sisters are Generation X. So, I mean, I'm very much influenced by this kind of stuff. Didn't realize until we hit the pre-chorus that this was actually a cover of the Cranberries. The way that they redid the chorus was great. The way their interpretation of the verse was also great. The guitar tone and the bass sound great. Quite a crunchy mix on the drums. A good choice, actually. Vocal performance is really good. I mean, some of the stuff in the verse I didn't dig as much, like his tone and his articulation, the way he was doing it. It has that kind of a hint of bro metal that I'm not a fan of. But I think that also has a lot to do with personal taste. Even if you look at it from an objective musician standard, everything was executed great. This is an excellent tribute. Like I said, I love the original, but honestly, I think I like this one more. As an added bonus, the guitar solo is pretty dang cool. Total grade for this song, plus sign. Rock Bottom by UFO. This song has like one main riff that it starts with and comes back to as kind of like its main theme of the song. Honestly, I don't think it was a good choice to do that. It's not a bad riff in and of itself. I would feel like it would be a better suited for a transitional riff in a bridge. I don't know, it just didn't feel right as being the main riff of the song to me. The melodies throughout are okay. They're not really gripping me, and I think that's because they have to write that melody over top of that riff. That riff is just not, it doesn't grip you. It's too moldable. The vocal performance is good. Accurate, soulful. At about 2 minutes when we're going into the bridge, we get like a palm mute transition. I like that. It's like the same riff, but they do it palm muted. Good use of dynamic. It was about this point in the song where I realized that this band is like the roots of my roots. At about 2:40, we start building a good groove into this really, really cool guitar solo. The guitar solo started out a little like, eh, I didn't know where it was going. And it wasn't bad, but it was a little, I don't know, it felt a little amateurish. But then by the time it picked up, about the last third of the solo, it really felt quite tasty. Honestly, I would have loved this solo if he just picked a little bit of a different melody and articulation at the beginning of it. This guitar tone and drum mix are very British New Wave. Though they had a lot cleaner production than a lot of their contemporaries, I would say if I had to change anything, it would have added a little bit more compression to a number of the tracks on here, possibly even a couple of the buses, just to kind of bring out some more of the subtleties and fill a little bit more of that sonic space. They also just needed a better mix on the bass in general. Like, there was some low end, but it was not nearly warm enough. Total grade for this song, equal sign. Dread Machine by Jared Dines and Company. There was a ton of YouTubers on this one. Absolutely love the intro. Beautiful tone, beautiful chords, beautiful performance. Just a cool riff in general. The following heavy riff was a cool riff. I just don't know if I would have chosen that guitar tone. It does fit the style, just not my preference. The vocals are kick-ass. Great melody, great harmonies, great articulation, great tone. Drum parts are great. Well done, Jared. All right. Now I know I'm gonna catch some shit for this, and if Glenn ever sees this, he's gonna ream me a new asshole. I think he put a little bit too much low end on the entire drum mix, in my humble opinion, sir. The toms got a little bit too boomy, and your snare didn't quite cut through. It felt too warm for a snare, honestly. Especially considering the genre that we're going for here. It just felt, the snare felt way too rounded. I would have preferred something a little more jagged. Other than that, the mix is fucking great. I'm sorry, this is the show where I call things out on the mix. I'm sorry, Glenn. Stevie T tearing it up on a shredderific solo, and again, just a little bit too much shred. Like the following solo, which I'm pretty sure that's Music Is Win. I don't know for sure, but the following solo after Stevie T was like super tasty. Wasn't that shreddy at all, but it felt fucking great. It felt melodic. And like, he needs to incorporate more of that into his solos. The guy has unbelievable technique, but it really doesn't get you anywhere if you don't say anything. Not that he doesn't say anything, but you know what I'm saying. I thought the second solo was way tastier, and they played a lot less notes. Just super great articulation, great choice of notes in his melody. Jared Dines' solo, I'd say, was kind of like an in-between on both of them, and it was really shreddy and was actually appropriate because they changed up the backing track behind the solo at that point. It was like really close to being amazing. Didn't quite get me there, though. Keeping in mind, I'm a guy critiquing these guitar players and drummers and whoever else as a guy who I couldn't play that fast. Then we follow this up by a clean solo, which is nice and legato, gorgeous, great tone. And also loved the ending. It was just this straight up rock, just slamming the chords as hard as you can. Good old school stuff. I expect no less from YouTube's finest. This is a really good song, especially for having written it and recorded it in 2 days. Excellent. By the way, I am like 90% sure this song is about the YouTube comments section. Total grade for this song, equal sign. Bed of Razors by Children of Bodom. Love the harp intro. It's kind of like macabre meets neoclassical. It's a ballsy move to use this intro as your main theme because it's really kind of awkward. The verse is actually damn cool. Not too complicated, but well composed and arranged so that it keeps you interested and engaged. Don't care for the vocals. The guitar tone is very mid-focused and treble-focused, and like, normally not a huge fan of it, but for the sound that was produced out of this song, actually works. This whole sound is very much like 80s and 90s. It works, but it is unusual. At about 1:30, it kind of gives us a little bit of a folk metal feel, and I think that's the chorus. I don't know for sure. At 1:56, we go into the bridge with this kick-ass cool riff with fantastic accents. Also, not expecting that much emphasis on like this harpsichord synth sound. For a guitar solo that was unirhythmic, great taste. Really good taste, man. Well done. The Keys solo was also cool. If Children of Bodom got a different singer, I would probably love this band. Total grade for this song, equal sign. To the End of the World by Aelstorm. Huge sound, as expected. I've already gone into the production before. It's great. I enjoy it. Moving on. Did not expect horns. Expected this rhythm for the song, but, you know, it's Aelstorm, so of course you're going to get this. Very, very loud master. I actually really like the composition. I think it would sound great on acoustic. The arrangement is kind of basic, but, I mean, again, to be expected, doesn't bother me. At about 150, there's a great build in verse 2 by going to, it's either 16th or 8th notes, I forget which, probably 16th. The vocals aren't quite my thing. I think if I saw these guys live, it would be fucking awesome. Like, I really want to see these guys live. At 330, I was not expecting that bridge. Really cool. I actually like the growl vocals that kind of come in around 435. Kind of goes into like a mellow guitar solo in a sense. I think it was a little low in the mix. The keys sounded really good, but the guitar solo was a little bit buried. I'm actually shocked that they made a 6-minute song that didn't bore me. Total grade for this song, equal sign. Save Your Breath by Five Finger Death Punch. Good groove in the intro. I can't tell if the guitar tone is too low or if the bass is bleeding over into it. Overall, I just want less lows in that mix. The melody is good, quite catchy in the verse. Actually, it's kind of surprising because this is one of the few songs where the verse is much catchier than the chorus, and the chorus isn't bad. Great use of rhythm and the melody of the verse. The drums are simple, but that's on purpose to let everything else shine. There's a lot happening rhythmically in all the other instruments. The mix is great, very loud master. Vocals are solid. Chorus is not typical. The outro of each of the choruses is actually quite cool. Really like that. I actually really like that guitar solo. My only complaint on that guitar solo is I would have changed the tone slightly. I don't know, it was just a little bit too distorted in some way. I would have to listen back to it to really pick it out. The articulation and note selection were spot on. The tone took me out of it just slightly. It was a poppy metal song and I actually liked it. Total grade for this song, plus sign. A Crow Left the Murder by Incubus. I'm digging the intro. Maybe a little too upbeat for me. The harmonic relationships in that main riff are really cool though. I think the rhythm and that rhythm in that tempo being it's so fast, like I think is just throwing me off a little bit. Melody is on point. In contrast, that chorus is excellent. The bridge, it kind of lays back a little further and gives us a subtle crescendo. The mix is a little dirtier than expected, especially for this era of Incubus. Kind of feels like there's a blanket over top of everything. Very low mids focused. It's a cool little song that is atypical. Don't know that it's my jam though. Total grade for this song, equal sign. Love Will Tear Us Apart by Joy Division. One of my buddies who was a $50 patron for like a number of months when I first had my Patreon really, really wanted me to do Joy Division. And I like kept trying to get it in there. I now regret that decision. This is kind of like a 60s/80s sound at the same time, but with good production. Not a fan of the synth. Just all of the timbres in this song, I do not like at all. The vocals are horrible, really bad. The bass line is the most interesting thing, and it's possibly the most cringe-inducing thing I've listened to. When the vocals started following the bass line, as in the vocal melody. Oh, the drums are hyper scooped as fuck. And to be fair, I can't tell if it's a guitar or a bass. Where the fuck is the low end of the bass tone? I actually kind of hate this song. It's not the fact that I hate them for making this. I hate the fact that they have any traction whatsoever. Like if I had listened to this song and someone from my audience said that they wrote it and they were like 13 years old, I wouldn't be fucking shocked. As a matter of fact, I'm more shocked than an established band wrote and recorded this song. Like it was embarrassment level. I would never put my name on anything that sounded like this. And the crazy thing is, the keys that I said that I don't like might actually work amazingly over another track. This is like if Sonic Youth could play on time of a metronome and not be Kings of Leon. I was so let down to the point where I really can't say anything else. Total grade for this song, minus sign. My Demons by Starset. Wasn't until we hit the chorus of this song that I realized I heard this song all the time and I have no idea where the fuck I hear it. The intro strings and synthesizer, really cool. I actually liked the vocal melody in this first verse. When they reprise it in the second verse, I kind of want to rip my hair out because I'm like, you guys set this up to be poppy and somewhat enjoyable, and then you fall back into like, no. You got lazy on me, man. That was not the best melody for that second verse, especially the way that you changed the backing music. You got lazy on me, motherfucker. Besides the melody, the vocals themselves are actually pretty killer. Extremely catchy chorus. Great melody in the chorus. Honestly, it's so catchy, I can't tell if I hate it or love it. I kind of want to punch it in the face. The kick and the snare feel fantastic. Guitar tone is solid. The bass feels like all low end, but I'm not really complaining. The mids of that bass are probably buried beneath the guitars. The bridge is cool-ish, but really honestly, they should have changed the chords that they used because they basically just recycled all the chords in a slightly different rhythm and a slightly different pattern of all the chords that we had already used in the song. I love and hate this song, and I don't know which feeling I'm feeling more. Total grade for this song, equal sign.
Bonus round.
Catherine from Elders React actually just finally got to do Elders React to Led Zeppelin. She has been praying for this for 6 years and finally got to do it. In honor of it, she actually gave a suggestion last week, which I wasn't able to put on, but basically any Zeppelin song that I want to do, and I decided to do it this week. I also almost forgot, which I'm really sorry, Catherine, but I didn't forget, and it's on this week. This is a song that I've definitely suggested before, Achilles Last Stand by Led Zeppelin. This song is epic in every fashion. I don't know if I'd necessarily say Led Zeppelin is one of my roots, though I have learned some of their stuff and listened to a significant amount of their stuff. I don't think that they've directly influenced me, but yet again, just like UFO, the roots of my roots. This song is like power metal before power metal was a thing. This song is so good. The riffs, the chords, especially the chord voicings, excellent. John Bonham's performance is off the chain. I mean, you feel like you're in the heat of battle because of his drum parts. Not to mention, as a drummer that did not use double kick and did not bury the beater, wow. The lyrics, honestly, the lyrics to me don't even register, but the vocals, freaking fantastic. Production is Led Zeppelin production, and we could go through that. This is honestly one of my, at least in my top 50 songs. It's a really damn good song. Especially for Zeppelin, who absolutely did do like the long 8-9 minute venture thing. This one I think is like, shit, close to 15 minutes or something like that. And is beyond most other Zeppelin songs that I've listened to, in my opinion. Mostly because of the energy, the lack of fucks given, like, amazing. For any of you young metalheads out there aspiring to make something fresh and new, allow this to be one of your core influences, one of your center spirits, if you will. Total grade for this song, every plus sign I have available.
I'm pretty sure I already suggested this, but I'm going to suggest it again. My suggestion to you this week is The River by Opeth. This song is kind of like, I don't even know, man. It's definitely classic prog. Like, you have a lot of Jethro Tull, maybe Emerson, Lake, and Palmer in there. But you also get some really interesting flavors, especially when they get to the Phrygian section. This song, the beginning is gorgeous, and the outro is like, you have lit my soul ablaze. Love this song. That is it for Song Suggestion Friday. Thank you so much for watching. Please leave your suggestions in the comments below. One suggestion per person per week, please. If you want to put your suggestions into the poll on Patreon, please go to my Patreon page. Link is in the description. I also do paid song critiques. If you would like me to critique your song that you wrote, please email me, becomethenight@gmail.com. You can also follow me at Facebook and Twitter at becomethenight. Thank you guys so much for watching. See you in the next video. Rock on!